गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशन लैब क्लास। ऑन टुडे क्लास विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग विद द चैप्टर 4 एंड विल बी डिस्कस अबाउट द रेस्ट ऑफ द इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल कमांड्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद चैप्टर 4, रेस्ट ऑफ द कमांड्स। नाउ द न्यू कमांड इज योर REN। It is used to rename a file. So syntax is your REN, then write down the old file name, then write down the new file name. Okay, see the example. You are working with C drive or it may be D drive. Okay, so you have to write REN, then file name is your document, then put a space, write down the new file name. Here I am writing SKDB, then press enter. So after writing this command, if you check the directory, you will be getting only one file, because rename means what? It will change the old name with the new name. Okay, so here the document name is changed with the new name, that is SKDAB. Now next is copy. It is used to make a duplicate copy of the source file. The target file name must be a new file name. Here syntax is copy, then you have to write the source file name, then you have to write the target file name. Okay, and the target file name must be the new file. So as for example, write down copy document, then space bio, means my document file is having another copy with the name of bio. Okay, now next is your type. It is used to display the contents of a file, that is only in readable mode, means only you are able to visualize the contents of a file. So your command is your type, then the file name. So now see, as for example, C prompt is there. I am writing type, then SKDAB. So here I am having document file is changed with the name of SKDAB. I am writing type SKDB, you may write type bio, you may write type document, whatever it may be. Okay. Now, the next command is del. It is used to remove a file from your disk. Means if I want to delete any file, how I should delete? By del command. So your syntax is del, then the file name, then you have to press the enter key. So example is your C prompt is there, write down del bio, then enter. Okay, now the next command is your MD. MD is making directory. It is used to create a new directory, and your syntax is MD, then the directory name. And as for example, I am writing MD, then the software. Okay, so here I am recalling some parts of your file and directory concept. File means what? It is the collection of data. But the directory means where list of files are there, just like your Windows folder. Okay, so how I will be creating the directory? By using the MD command. Okay, now how to go inside to the directory? The command is your CD. So CD stands for change the directory. It is used to change the directory name. The syntax is your CD, then the directory name, then you have to press the enter key. Now my directory name is software. So here also I am writing CD software, then enter. Means you are coming from C drive to software directory. Okay. Now next is your RD. As you are creating the directory, change the directory, one more command must be there to remove that directory. Okay. So to remove the file, your command is del, but to remove the directory, your command is RD. So RD stands for remove directory. It is used to remove the directory. But some rules are there. Rules of remove directory command. While removing the directory, always parent directory should be activated. Then we should remove the child directory. Means remaining in parents, you can delete the child. Before deleting the directory, it must be empty. Okay. The directory name or file name are not same. So we remember all these rules, then you can remove the directory by using the RD command. So here the syntax, RD, then the directory name. and example is your RD software. Okay, now some extra commands are there related to your MD, CD and RD, that are your CD double dot, CD double dot backslash double dot and CD backslash also. CD double dot means what? It back for one step. Means suppose you are activating in your child directory, if you want to back for one step, your command is CD double dot. Now see the example. Now I am in C users user. Okay, so when I am writing CD double dot enter, so automatically I will be activating with the C user directory. Okay, just like your back button of your Windows folder concept. Clear? Now next is CD double dot slash double dot. This one is for one step and this one is for two step. Okay, the syntax is your CD double dot backslash double dot, then you have to press enter. So here the example, as you are in C user user, when you are writing this command, automatically you are moving to where? To the C drive. Okay, because back for two step, this one first step, this one second step, now you are back to the first step. Okay, now CD backslash, it activate the root directory. Okay, that means no need of writing this type of command, you can direct write the CD backslash. So when you write CD backslash, now see on the example C user user, when I am writing CD backslash enter, automatically I move to the C prompt. Okay, and for two step, three step, you have to write double dot slash double dot slash double dot, like such a manner. Otherwise you may write the simple direct command, that is called CD backslash enter. Okay, so now we start the DOS prompt, where we should execute all this command one by one. Now on my search option I am writing cmd, or you may write command. Okay, so now this is the DOS prompt. As this is C user account is there, so first if you want to move to D drive, write down D colon. This is the concept of changing of drive from C to D, or it may be anything. So here I am not having the D drive, so I move to E drive. Okay, now I clear the screen, and first time I am creating one new file. Over up to this much, I write down the data for biodata file and I save the file by pressing Ctrl Z, or you may press F6. Over, file is saved. Now start with the rename command. So here your file name is biodata, check in directory, write dir. Now see, here the biodata file is there with 36 bytes each occupied, date of creation and time of creation. Okay, now I have to rename the file. So your command is ren, write down the old file name. Okay, then write the new file name. I am writing new bio. Okay, so my command is ren, old file name is your biodata, then put a space and write down the new file name. Be remember, this new file name is not exist on your directory. Okay, after this command you write dir to check whether your file is renamed or not. Now see, as per this output, biodata is here, but now see, there is no biodata. Okay, now the file name became change with new bio. Okay, Now see this one. New bio 36 and same date and time is there. Clear? Next, copy a file. So as I am having the file name is new bio, I am writing copy new bio and my new file name is resume. Okay, so here the new bio file is copy with the new name with resume. Okay, press enter. One file copied means on your directory two files are there, one is new bio and next one is your resume. Okay, so how you should check? Again go for the command of dir. New bio is there and resume is there. Okay, same bytes is there. So next question arises, how to check the contents of the file? So copy command is there, rename command is there, and next command is your to check the contents of a file. Your command is type. I am writing type new file. Means type is a command to check the contents of a file. Only for read purpose, not for write. Over. Now again I am writing type. My new file name is your resume. Okay. So as I am having two files, one is your new bio, another one is your resume. So by type command again I am checking the contents of resume file. Now see, new bio is having the contents with the same contents resume is having, that same thing. Okay, so make a copy means only the name is changed and contents is copied to next target file. Clear? Next is how to delete a file. So before deleting a file, first you should check the directory and be confirm which file you want to delete. And be remember, those files are unnecessary for you, you may delete that file. Okay? Because after deleting of this file, it cannot be recalled. As per Windows format, if you delete the file, it is placed to shifted to your recycle bin, and from that recycle bin you may recall that file or restore that file. But in case of DOS, if you delete a file, it can't be recalled. Okay, so here I see that I have to delete this new bio file. Okay, so be confirm regarding this file, then go for writing the command del new bio, then enter. Okay, no message is display, but how you should confirm? Go for the command of dir. Now see, here I am having the new bio file with 36 bytes. Here you don't have the new bio file, only the resume file is there. Clear? Now clear the screen. So next command is create the directory by using your MD command. So MD command is used to create a directory. So I am writing MD. My directory is, suppose I am writing ABC. This is my directory name. Okay. So already this name is exist. Okay. Now see, a subdirectory or file ABC is already exist. So don't use the same name for the repetition. Okay. So again I am using, this one is not created. If I am writing MD XYZ. Okay, no message display means on the name of XYZ your new directory is created. Clear? Now MD command is for creating this directory. So how you will be confirm? Go for the using dir command. Now see, as ABC is one file is there, that's why the error message is display XYZ. XYZ is a directory. So how you know that this one is a directory? Now here the dir symbol is display for directory. Okay, but for the file there is no symbol, only the bytes is there. Yes, one more thing is there, as per creating the directory, it is not occupying any space from your hard disk. whereas whenever you are creating any file, it should occupy some frame from your hard disk. That's why, what is the difference between file and directory? File is the collection of data. Because as much of data you are storing in a file, it will occupy the space that is measured in terms of bytes. Whereas folder or directory means what? It is the collection of files. Okay, that's why directly it is not occupying any space or storage space from your hard disk. That's why the bytes is not displayed to you. Clear? Now, how to go inside into that directory? So I am writing cd xyz. Okay, now see, this is the path concept. When you are writing cd xyz, from E directory, E drive, you are moving to which directory? XYZ directory. Clear? Then again I am writing MD PQR, or I am writing MD double A. Another new directory I am creating. Inside where? Inside your XYZ. So if I write CD double A, now see, you are moving to double A directory. The total path is, you are in E drive, XYZ directory, and inside XYZ, one double A directory is there, where you are able to create any file or you may create any new directory also. Clear? Now, CD directory name is activated. Now I want to back from that directory. So you may write CD double dot. Double dot E means back to the parent directory. One step back. Now see. Okay. Again I am writing CD double A. I am into the double A directory. For two step back. This one is for one step back. Okay. For two step back, you may write CD double dot slash double dot. Now see. Two step back means to the E drive. Now the E drive is activated. Clear? Again I am moving to XYZ. Again CD double A. Clear? Now the last command is back to the root. Okay, for back option, CD double dot is there. Now double dot slash double dot is there. And last one is your CD backslash. Okay, now see, same command. CD backslash is back to the root. Clear? Now for remove the directory. Again I give the command as CLS. You are having XYZ. Okay. Now write the command dir. Okay. So here inside XYZ you are having one AA directory. So as per the rules, it asks you, you have to activate the parent directory, and inside that parent directory you are able to remove the child directory. Clear? So here I am writing rd double A, enter. Okay. Now this double A directory is removed. Go for writing the command as dir. Now see, here there is no double A directory, means totally this directory is empty. Clear? Then you have to delete the XYZ. So write the command cd double dot, because one step back, or you may write cd backslash enter also. Clear? Now you are able to delete the XYZ directory also. Okay, so I am writing rd XYZ. Now I am writing dir. So no more XYZ directory is there. Clear? So practice all these sorts of commands, then we will be discuss about the lab work where these commands is to be used. Okay, so all these are your internal command. In the next video, we will be discuss about the lab work and the external commands. Okay.